days I know I need a helping hand, 'cause all around me's sinking sand. When worries of this world are hard to bear, I just remember God knows everything, and with God's help I can do anything. And I'm happy just to know that I'm God's child.
God is my portion,
God is my
rock, the rock on which I stand.
I tell you, this music team is awesome. Woo-hoo. Good morning. How are y'all? Me too. Good. And welcome to all those that are live streaming. And let us not forget all of you in attendance today. Praise God. We cannot do any of this without all of you. Every one of you. Oh, okay, I'm done. Some announcements today. I call your attention to this insert in your bulletin, and the bulletin is yours to keep. First Wednesdays is finally here, Wednesday evening, 6 p.m. Experiencing Our Unity begins. There will be a community potluck, scrap that. Ooh. It's going to be a community meal provided by Unity, so don't bring anything. And at 6 p.m., we're going to have our dinner. At 6:45, we are going to have our wonderful activity for this month. There'll be a different activity each month, but oh my gosh, this is going to be good. Should I say what it is?
Go ahead.
Okay. It's going to be, you know, you all just come and do your wonderful specialties. Tell
them. It's a talent show.
Yay, God. Okay, cool. And at 1:30 today, Dr. Michael Obsas is going to be facilitating a special class from 1:30 to 3:30. And it's on how do we turn our traumatic experiences into gifts and blessings. This workshop will help support participants in the process of healing and transformation. So please don't miss this. This is going to be wonderful, as usual. He's so wonderful. Are you looking for meaningful connections on your spiritual path? Well, Spirit Circle Weekends will be groups of about 8 people meeting weekly over coffee, lunch, or dinner. Groups will gather in individual host homes or other locations to break bread together and enjoy spiritual fellowship. So sign up now in the Garden Court. Space is limited. So, and last but not least, is Saturday, February 11th at 10:30 at the Lodge in Robbinsdale, the Volunteer Appreciation Brunch. Oh my goodness, this is going to be so wonderful. It's like it is every year, just wonderful. And no cost to you, but we do need you to pick up your tickets in the bookstore, just so we know a count for the lodge to let them know how many people will be coming. So check it out, grab your ticket, and let us know. Just come on down. Okay. Many other classes and events here going on at Unity Minneapolis, so if you have any specific questions, check the garden court, your insert, and your bulletin, which again is yours to keep, Peak of the Week, our website, and if you can't find any answers to something specific, give us a call. We're here Sunday through Thursday. And if you have your cell phone or electronic device with you today, before you silence them, if you feel called to do so, check in on Facebook and let them know that they too are welcome here, no matter where they are on their spiritual journey. Amen. So let's begin our service with prayer. Let's just take in a breath. We thank you, sweet Spirit. We thank you for this glorious day. We thank you that this is the year our dreams are coming true. We thank you for all of the gifts you shower on us every single second of every single day. Praise God. And we thank you for our spiritual community, the volunteers, the congregants, everything. And we pray this in the name and through the power of Jesus the Christ. And so it is. And so we let it be. Amen. Thank you. Let's celebrate this glorious day. It is sunny out. Unless it's lights. I don't know. And we begin our service affirming together our core value, vision, and mission statement. And they are found in your bulletins. So let's start with our core values. Together, we are loving, transforming, welcoming, spirit-filled, prosperous, and joyful. And our vision, centered in spirit, we celebrate a world transformed by love, peace, and compassion. And our mission statement, we are a vibrant, inclusive, prosperous, spiritual community, inspiring and empowering full expression of the divine within through prayer, education, and service. And I invite our on-duty prayer chaplains to please stand. These individuals arrived early today to hold sacred space for us. They are here to support you in prayer for any celebrations, joys, or concerns you'd like to pray about. So please, seek one of them out. I assure you, it'll be a blessing to them as well as for you. So thank you. So let's stand for our opening song, Amazing Things. The words are printed in your bulletin.
You will do amazing things with the choice each new day brings. And every step you take, bless the progress that you make. The reason you live, from every gift you give. Love your life, love your dreams, you will do amazing. Don't worry when or where or how. You don't have to know right now. You're on the right track. No need to look ahead or back. Just enjoy what this day brings. You will do amazing things. Amazing, amazing. You will do amazing things. Amazing, amazing. You will do amazing. Stay in the here and now. Let your mind rest for a little while. Sometimes deepest answers come when you're out there having fun. So close your eyes, take a breath and smile.
Song for this series. And you're probably asking yourself, where's Reverend Pat? Well, Reverend Pat is off doing amazing things. In fact, he's in Hawaii right now. Not just for vacation, though. He's actually ordaining Reverend Gio Downer this weekend. So, yay! And we know Gio will do amazing things in ministry. And for those of you who may not know who Gio is, he's been mentoring with Reverend Pat, and he's come to visit and be a part of this community several times. So we just hold him in our heart as he walks through this weekend. Now's the time in our service where we truly honor and bless those who might be here experiencing a Sunday service with Unity Minneapolis for the first time, whether you're here in the sanctuary or online. We are truly grateful for your presence. And I invite you to put your courage in your hand and raise your hand along with me. Our ushers have a packet of information that we would like to share with you. Any newcomers? Any first, second, or third time? This is your first, second, or third time. Yay, we have one there. Yay. Thank you for being here this morning. And our joy is that if you hear anything this morning, you hear this. Wherever you are on your spiritual journey, and this is for everyone here in this room and online, wherever that may be, you are truly welcome here. Let's celebrate our guest. Yay. And now we celebrate each other. We do that with a handshake, with a hug, and namaste. Please ask before you hug.
Thank you.
So hopefully by now you've caught the eye of that one person you really wanted to hug across the room. And if you didn't quite make it there, I invite you to connect over coffee and hospitality after the service. And now that you're all sitting down, I'm going to invite you to stand as we join together in singing, God is my source.
God is my power. God gives me everything I need. So I give thanks for all my blessings. God gives me everything. Love is my source.
Love is my source.
Love is my power.
Love gives me everything I need. So I give thanks for all my blessings.
Love gives me everything.
Joy, joy, joy.
Joy is my source. Joy is my power. Joy gives me everything I need.
Hey!
So I give thanks for all my blessings. Joy gives me everything I need.
Peace is my source.
Peace is my source.
Peace is my power. Peace gives me everything I need.
So I give thanks
for all my blessings. Peace gives me everything.
Sing, God is my source. God is my source.
God is my power.
My power.
God gives me
everything. Every little thing. Every day, every time, anyway.
I
give thanks
for all of
my blessings.
God gives me.
We now move deeper into spirit with the reading of the daily word and the singing of Surely the Presence. As the usher brings down the prayer box, you are invited to mentally add your prayers to the box. Your prayers are then prayed with by our prayer ministry for 7 days, and then they are forwarded to Silent Unity, where they are prayed with for an additional 30 days. The word for today, Sunday, January 29th, 2017, is healing. I live from the truth of my being. I am whole, strong, and well. I was born in the image and likeness of the great Creator. As such, perfect health is my divine inheritance as a child of God. I recall the story of the woman who touched the fringe of Jesus' garment and was immediately healed. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well." Like this woman, my faith enlivens and strengthens me. I reach within and touch God through prayer. I affirm the truth of my body's natural healing ability and envision the radiating light of God working in me now to establish the highest manifestation of my physical being. Every cell is infused with life-creating properties. I am renewed and revitalized from head to toe. My heart overflows with gratitude for the gift of health and wholeness. And from Luke 8:48, he said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace." The word for today is healing.
presence of God is in this place. I can feel the mighty power and grace. There's a holy hush around us. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of God is in this place. Surely the presence of God is in this place. I can feel the mighty power and grace. Surely the presence of God is in this place.
Now let us relax in our chairs, being as relaxed as possible, and allow your mind to grow peaceful. As you relax, focus your awareness on your breathing. Each time you breathe, know that you are breathing in the joy, the love, the peace, the bliss of God. And feel it permeate and penetrate your whole being. We know the joy, love, peace, and bliss of God is present in our every moment. No matter what the conditions about us or our world. Peace within us, peace around us. The Christ light illumines our way. We place our hope and faith in the healing power of God within. We joyfully give and we joyfully receive. We share our peace with the world. Let us rest for a moment in the silence and know that everything is good and everything is God. And so we rest. And now, as we return to this space in time, we know that despite appearances in our lives or our world, God is present and everything is good when we remember our truth. And so it is, and so we let it be. Amen.
We are so blessed in this community. The music is just amazing. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Wonderful, wonderful, fortunate you. This is the year that your dreams come true. That's our theme. That has been our theme for this entire month. And those lines are from a poem that is on the cover of your bulletin. I hope that you have found it uplifting. I have. I've truly found it uplifting knowing that I am the one, that you are the one that has the power to move in the direction of your dreams. That your dreams are calling you, that it's God calling to express through you, and realizing that our dreams, our heart's desire, are truly about us being God in expression. And it's not just our job to move in the direction of those dreams, it's our job to expect them to come true. After all, what we focus on, what we expect in life, is what we are telling the universe we want to manifest in our lives. So let me tell you a story. And this story is from an episode of a show in the 60s called The Twilight Zone. The story begins with the death of a small-time thief whose name is Rocky. And Rocky has considered himself very unlucky for his entire life. And now he's in the afterlife, and he kind of takes that with him. However, Rocky meets someone named Pip. And he believes that Pip is his guardian angel. And Pip tells him, anything you ask for, anything, whatever it is, you can have it. And so Rocky starts asking. He starts asking for things like unlimited luck at the casino, asking for things like to be desired by beautiful women. And at first, he kind of thought it was fun. In fact, he thought it was heavenly. However, as the months went by, it got kind of old. It got kind of boring, and it wasn't such a pleasant experience anymore. And one day, in a fit of rage, Rocky grabbed Pip and says, if I gotta stay here another day, I'm going to go nuts. I don't belong in heaven, see? I want to go to the other place. Pip's response, heaven? What made you think that you were in heaven? This is the other place. Heaven on earth is not about having everything that we want right here and right now. You know, the true reward, the true promise of paradise is about how we live the journey. That said, how often do our dreams come true and yet we allow them to slip away? Have you, heard about the lottery winners? Yeah, most of us have heard that story. And quite frankly, I can tell you from my life, I know that it happens all the time. There's a book called The Big Leap by Gay Hendricks. And in this book, he talks about the upper limit problem. I almost forgot what it was called. Sorry about that. He calls it the upper limit problem. And here's how he describes that problem. I have a limited tolerance for feeling good. When I hit my upper limit, I manufacture thoughts that make me feel bad. The problem is bigger than just my internal feelings. I seem to have a limited tolerance for my life going well in general. When I hit my upper limit, I do something that stops my positive forward trajectory. I get into a conflict with my ex-wife. I get into a money bind. I do something that brings me back down within the bounds of my limited tolerance. Ring any bells? Feel a little familiar sometimes? It sure did for me. He talks about the idea that this is what keeps us from living. Can you still hear? There it goes. It went away for a second there. This is what keeps us from living 24/7 in what he calls our zone of genius, in what I might call our dream manifestation zone. A big leap, the title of the book, that can only happen when we are truly willing to break the conscious and subconscious chains of limitation that are keeping us from experiencing unlimited good in our lives. Here's the thing. We have to be willing to allow the journey to change us. And when we don't, we experience something called chemicalization. In Unity's classic text, Lessons in Truth, Dr. Emily Cady has an entire chapter on a process called chemicalization, which Charles Fillmore describes in The Revealing Word. Charles Fillmore is one of the co-founders of Unity, and he describes chemicalization as this way: a condition in the mind that is brought about by the conflict that takes place when a high spiritual realization contacts an old error state of consciousness. So you have two thought paradigms coming together, and they create chemicalization. They clash with each other. So a little bit of Unity history. The chapter on chemicalization in Dr. Cady's book was actually left out for a number of years in several editions of the book, because there was a thinking that maybe, you know, reading that chapter or focusing on this process was actually causing people to experience chemicalization. Well, thankfully, we as a movement woke up. And we woke up to the idea of understanding that chemicalization is a natural part of the creative process. One of my mentors, Reverend Ed Townley, was prone to saying, "It is something that occurs whether we believe it or not." And the danger actually is that we don't recognize it for what it is. Old embedded thoughts fighting with our new thoughts. And we've all heard the saying, things always appear to get worse before they get better. That's chemicalization. It seems like we get where we want to go, and then suddenly it feels like we're taking two steps backward. You know, Emmett Fox, one of the great classic New Thought writers, talks about it in this way. It seems as though everything begins to go wrong at once. This may be disconcerting, but it really is a good sign. Suppose your whole world seems to rock on its foundation. Hold steady and let it rock. And when the rocking is over, the picture will have reassembled itself into something that is much nearer to your heart's desire. Wasn't what you expected him to say, was it? Call it good. Know it is good. What if instead of taking two steps backwards, we saw it as God? There's only one presence and one power in the universe. As love in action, as divine order unfolding. Maybe a little uncomfortable for us to experience, yet not negative. Friday, I had the opportunity to go see the movie Hidden Figures. Oh my, highly recommend. If you haven't seen it, I'd put it on my list. If you really are interested in my opinion. But I haven't been able to stop thinking about the idea that the person who was leading the drive at NASA to put a man into orbit successfully and successfully bring him back said that he knew that they could do it. And he knew that they could do it because in his mind, it was already done. In his mind, it was already done. And all they needed to do was change their math, change their thoughts to be in alignment with the dream, to be in alignment with what they knew was already done. Want to live your dreams? Know that you are already there. And when you experience what appears to be resistance, know it is chemicalization, and meet it with non-resistance. I've talked about it up here before, that Jesus has had a reference to putting new wine into new wineskins. Because when we put new wine into old wineskins, that fermentation process is not allowed to expand because the old wineskins have completely lost their elasticity and they will burst. But if we put new wine into new wineskins, there's an expansiveness that can happen. The new wine can grow and ferment. I believe that this is the chemicalization. It's what we are experiencing, quite frankly, in the world today, right now, is chemicalization. Sometimes it seems like things are getting worse because we're putting the new wine into old wineskins. It feels as if we're moving backwards. When what's really happening is new thought systems are bumping up against old thought systems, old wineskins, and that aren't able to expand, and that process is causing chemicalization. So often we turn to blame and judgment. In John chapter 9, verses 1 and 2, Jesus talks about this. He tells a story. As he walked along, he saw a man born blind from birth. His disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" The disciples are asking, whose fault is it? What have we done? What have his parents done? What has he done that he is being punished? They're assuming there's something wrong, something negative going on. And Jesus answered, "Neither this man nor his parents sinned." Sin meaning missing the mark. "He was born blind so that God's works might be revealed in him." Jesus came to this from a place of neutrality, from a place where he could trust that God is at work, no matter what it looks like. God is at work. And that's it, the end of the sentence. There's no, "Oh, well, maybe despite appearances, I can maybe possibly believe that God's at work here." He knew it, without a doubt. He didn't question that his good, that this young man's good was expressing, because he saw it all as God. In fact, I believe that he knew when we are willing to allow the journey to manifesting our dreams change us, we don't have to experience chemicalization. Because there's no clash. The new thoughts are transforming the old thoughts as we journey. So it's a much more gentle process. We just don't tend to take it that way. We tend to need that chemicalization, need that resistance to really look at changing. I came across an article online about chemicalization that identified four stages to what he called the healing process. The first stage is when we begin to realize a new truth. That seed of a new possibility is planted and we begin to question our old ways. This can be a gentle process. It doesn't have to be a huge paradigm shift. Or it can be a huge paradigm shift, which can cause a bit of a storm. And in that case, sometimes we may be inclined to abandon ship. Even then, the seed has already been planted. The seed has already been planted and it is already going, so that no matter what choice we make, that seed is growing. You know, I remember stepping into these teachings as a teenager at Unity Village. It felt good. It resonated with me. And I had grown up Catholic grade school for 8 years. It was pretty indoctrinated into me. And at some point, those two thought systems clashed. And I left Unity. I now see that that was the right and perfect choice for me to make, because I had some learning and growing to do. But boy, was it a chaotic experience in my life. However, the seed had been planted. And when I was ready to change, unity was there. I knew where to go. The second stage is the upheaval. Once we begin denying power to our false beliefs, our subconscious may create even more chaos, trying to convince us to abandon our dreams. You know, if you're in a prosperity class, this just might be that moment when suddenly it appears that you are even less prosperous than when you signed up to take the class. You know, that's those that old paradigm just trying to get our attention. And when we can know that it is chemicalization and call it that, we don't have to slide into fear and resistance. And this is, again, not to say that you must experience a huge upheaval to hold on to your dreams. It is to say that if you do, it's natural. Name it, claim it, know it that it is part of your highest good. And stop in the midst of the upheaval and you know, we talk about denials and affirmations. Stop in the midst of it. Deny that it has any power over you and affirm something like, I am a child of God. There is nothing to fear. Peace, love, and joy are my divine inheritance. I'm going to say that one more time and then ask you to affirm it with me. I am a child of God. There is nothing to fear. Peace, love, and joy are my divine inheritance. Together? I am a child of God. There is nothing to fear. Peace, love, and joy are my divine inheritance. Feel good? Yeah, it resonates. The next stage is one of letting go. Letting go of that which no longer serves us. Loving that old wineskin, and realizing that if we want to continue dreaming, we must let it go. It has served its purpose. In my journey to sobriety, this was the moment when I realized that there were some people that I loved dearly who I needed to let go of because they couldn't see me for who I was. And we were vibrating at different levels. And it was causing upheaval in our lives. And that was not okay. It was not serving them. It was not serving me. Because it was time for both of us to live in new possibilities. It didn't make them wrong. Didn't make me right. It just was the journey. It was where we were at in that moment of the journey. And I can still hold the vision. And it has come true in some cases of John Lennon's song that we just listened to that maybe someday we'll join together and be as one. And then the final stage is fulfillment. You begin to feel healthier. You begin to feel more prosperous, more abundant, more joyous, more peaceful, more of whatever it is that you are dreaming. You moved fully into your new wineskin, and there is an expansiveness where your higher consciousness can express more fully. And it's essential at this stage to keep listening to spirit, to keep listening to that voice within, because it can be tempting to go and shout from the highest mountain, look at me, look what I've done. And when that's not spirit guiding us to do that, it's ego guiding us to get attention. It's probably going to bring back chemicalization. Because the ego's not meant to drive the bus. The ego is not bad. It's not wrong. It's just not the one who's meant to guide us on our journey. You've heard Reverend Pat talk about something called the grace prayer. It has had a tremendous impact in my life. It's something that I learned when I was a licensed Unity teacher from Reverend Debbie Tyson. And it is a very powerful prayer. I'm going to share it with you. I would invite you not to use it unless you really want transformation to happen in your life. Because it is a consciousness conditioner. It really works at a deep level. Or at least it did for me. And it goes like this. I thirst. into thy hands I commit my body, spirit, mind, this situation, whatever it is you might be going through. Thy will is my will. Heal me at depth. Reveal that which needs to be revealed to me. Heal that which needs to be healed in me so that I may glorify you, God. It is finished. Amen. I was just finishing ministerial school, and I'd had this awareness that something was holding me back from being who I was meant to be as a minister, from being and doing that which was mine to do. And I pulled out this prayer and began praying it because I wanted to transform whatever that was and fully step into my calling. And I went on a journey of chemicalization that was a bit wild. Many of you know this story. It wasn't long before I was in the hospital with unexplained abdominal pain. And to shorten the story, within a few years, my body was diagnosed with a rare disease, and I was told that I had less than 3 years to live. Quite a process of chemicalization, and yet I was surrounded by people who knew to call it that. People who knew to support me in knowing that that was not the truth of who I am. And, you know, 5 years later, it's in complete remission. And I am living my dream. I am doing what I am called to do and dreaming even bigger dreams with you as we do this thing called ministry together. And so there's one final piece that I think is vital before we close out this series. And that's what I just said. Do not ever quit dreaming. Do not quit dreaming. I can't say it any better than John Lennon said it. Be a dreamer. You don't have to achieve one dream and that's it. You're done. It's all over. It just isn't the way it works. You know, in that movie that I watched Friday, the moment that they achieved putting a man into orbit and bringing him home, I mean, the very moment that that capsule landed in the ocean, the conversation was around getting to the moon and how they knew it would happen because in their mind, they were already there. So, in our mind, are we already in our dream? Let's affirm our poem together. It's on the cover of your bulletin. And stand in this knowing that this is true. Maybe even picture yourself looking into your own eyes in a mirror as you say this. Wonderful, wonderful, fortunate you. This is the year that your dreams come true. This is the year that your ship comes in. This is the year you find strength within. This is the year you are glad to live. This is the year you have much to give. This is the year when you know the truth. This is the year when you find new youth. This is the year that brings happiness. This is the year you will live to bless. Wonderful, wonderful, fortunate you. This is the year that your dreams come true. I behold the Christ in each of you. Namaste.
Come on, put your hands together. Come on, choir, let's encourage them out there. Here we go, yep. Let's tell them that the blessing of Abraham is on their life. You are Abraham's heirs, and and you have an inheritance on your life. That's right. Here we go, y'all. By faith.
By faith, we sing the blessing of Abraham.
It's all on your life, that's right.
The blessing of Abraham.
Wherever.
Wherever you are,
whatever you touch.
Whatever you touch is anointed.
You are the seed.
You are
by faith.
By faith,
the blessing of Abraham.
Blessing of Abraham.
The blessing is on you today. That's right. Blessing.
The blessing of Abraham.
It's all in your life.
The blessing of Abraham.
All right, make some noise out there. You gonna go get it? Come on, y'all, choir, wherever.
Wherever you are, wherever.
Whatever you touch.
Whatever you touch is anointed.
You are the
you
seed
are
by faith.
By faith.
The blessing.
The blessing of Abraham.
It's on your life. Yep. Come on, y'all. Let's tell them what it is. Come on, choir. Tell them, tell them, tell them. Get it, get it. Oh, yes.
By faith.
The blessing. All right, let's say it for somebody just one more time. Tell them what it is, choir. Here we go. Come on now. All right, here we go. We're getting ready to start a business, a practice. Yeah, we're gonna write a book, score a film, who knows? Yep, somebody's gonna walk right out of here and walk right into their inheritance. It's true. Come on, tell them what it is. Say it's yours.
It's yours. Yeah. It's yours. It's your inheritance. It's yours. It's yours. It's your inheritance. It's yours. It's yours. It's your inheritance. It's yours. It's yours. It's yours.
All right. God made you the head.
Get your inheritance.
your inheritance. Those seeds have been planted, so we know those seeds are growing. I look forward to seeing where your dreams take you on these journeys. So we got things flying in the back. There's things going on. So I invite our ushers to come forward as we prepare to give our gifts, our tithes, our gifts, our financial gifts to this community to support and power the work of this ministry, to truly put life into our vision and mission, to transform lives and truly bring forth the highest good. So we take those gifts in our hands and we infuse them with blessings as we affirm together our affirmation that's printed in the bulletin. Together, divine love flowing through me blesses and multiplies all that I give, all that I receive, and all that I am. Now take that awareness into your heart and truly know it to be true. We are blessed and truly grateful. Thank you, God. Amen. For those of you joining the service online, there is a donate button where you too can participate in this sacred activity of giving as we truly honor and bless this community if we have been spiritually fed here. And so we bless these gifts and truly know that these are the bounty of God. We send them forth with wisdom and with joy to do God's work. Amen. I want to remind everyone that there is a workshop here this afternoon at 1:30 with Dr. Michael Obesatz, who is, oh, no, he stepped away. I was going to have him stand. And then there are sign-up sheets out in the garden court for our Spirit Circle weekends. Space is limited, so sign up if it's yours to do. And if there's not a time there that works for you, maybe you're being called to facilitate a group. And you should check in with me and see if that's a possibility, because we could still add a few more groups. I think we should call our children in. Shall we do that?
We are walking in the light, in the light, in the light. We are walking in the light, in the light of God. In the light, 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 in the light of God.
You are walking
in the light, in the light.
are walking in the light of God. In the light of God. In the light, 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 in the light of God.
Hello?
Okay, I'm Rowan.
I'm Logan.
That's Logan. So we're both Why Are Yours, and today is actually, not only is it a fifth Sunday, but it's a super special fifth Sunday. So every fifth Sunday, Why Are You goes and leads and helps out, facilitate the younger kids. You know, kind of gives us a growing experience, you know, learn how to be teachers, but then also gives them some fun activities to do, like that. but today, we had this really cool thing. It's done every 6 weeks, but it's a kid pack. And usually it's done on Wednesdays, but we were lucky enough to be able to do it on Sunday. So what we did was the kids decorated their own bag, like a bag for... a lunch bag, basically, and it has someone's name on it, and their grade, and all that stuff, and we're gonna give it to kids at Noble Elementary School, so that's actually a couple blocks away from church, and basically, it's for the kids in need who are, the kids in need there who may not be able to afford stuff over the weekend. So basically, what we did was, after they decorated, they went into the room up there, and they all kind of just packed a bunch of stuff in the bags, and it was really cool. It was a nice bonding experience. They got to feel like they're making a difference, and you know, it'll be delivered on Friday, so they'll be able to get food. It's awesome.
Thank you guys for hanging out with our kids and facilitating them being of service in such a huge way, and for all of our adult volunteers who get the day off. We celebrate you too. There's a few that were here, but I love that the YOU steps in and helps make that happen. Do you guys have fun making the bags?
Yeah.
Yay. Yay. Well, let's join together now and affirm our prayer for protection and our peace song together. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is swell.